Center opened up, the Disney folks had a chance to show off some of the things that they had pioneered. And today, nearly 20 years later, some of those things continue to amaze people. I'm talking about the audio animatronics. If you've been over here, chances are you've seen the bears at the Country Bear Jamboree, or perhaps Mark Twain or Ben Franklin at the American Adventure over at Epcot. Well, tonight we're going to meet the man who took the magic of Disney animation and added the look of real life.
They are one of Disney's greatest achievements, bringing life to scenes that sometimes scare us, sometimes educate us, and always amuse us. They are the audio animatronic figures of Disneyland, Disney World, and the newest of the Disney amusement areas, Epcot Center.
Look, you see, right up here now.
The man who breathes life into the otherwise motionless machines is Wathel Rogers. Wathel started with Disney 43 years ago as a delivery boy, and now heads the department that brings life to everything from policemen to dinosaurs. The main piece of equipment used in bringing these mechanical actors to life is this board called the animation console.
Wathel, so tell me, how does it work?
Well, what we've done is we've designed this console with a human figure in mind. And on this console, you'll see that it has arms, legs, heads, feet, tail. And each one of these functions has its own knob. And when we press the button and illuminate the little switch over here, you see the one that's illuminated, and it says elbow, why then we know that we can turn that knob and the figure out there, then we'll move its arm. Or in this particular case, we have a head turn or a nod, and when we turn that, the figure nods.
What actually makes the figure move are tiny hydraulics built inside that are controlled by the knobs. All of the movements can be recorded by way of underground wires on computer tapes and discs located in another building. This information is transferred to another computer called the Show Control Unit. It can play back the movements of hundreds of different figures located all over Epcot Center with the touch of a single button. All this technology can be traced back to the ideas of one man, Walt Disney.
I think one of his dreams was to have some type of control over figures that would be very reliable and easy to do and lifelike.
Now, with the programming system and figures as advanced as these, I had to ask Wathel how much these computerized characters are worth.
I honestly couldn't answer that. I wouldn't even try to answer it because I was once told not to worry about that. It's a show quality. It's a show that is the important thing.
Well, whatever they cost, it's a good investment. These automated figures have become synonymous with Disney entertainment. And the Disney organization is recognized worldwide as the leader in audio animatronic technology. But what Wathel's team can now program in a few seconds used to take hours, even days, to do. 19 years ago, Wathel put together the very first audio animatronic show, the Tiki Birds in Disneyland, California. A remote control unit from a model airplane kit served as the power behind these early figures. When Walt Disney decided to use human-sized figures in his shows, Wathel developed this complex but effective device where sensors strapped to his body transmitted his movements to the movable joints in the figure. People were fascinated by the sight of President Abraham Lincoln standing there talking to them. He was first displayed at the 1965 New York World's Fair, and Wathel well remembers the reaction at the Illinois Pavilion.
We were right next to a Japanese pavilion where they made ball bearings, and every night we had to clean up the ball bearings on the stage because people were throwing and with slingshots shooting Lincoln to see if he would jump because they felt he was an actor. So when you can, you know, when you can bring that off, I think you feel a certain satisfaction about it.
And that's one thing that hasn't changed over the years, Wathel's satisfaction and pride in all the shows that he and his staff have created. And as they finished up the animation of this printing press scene, you can understand Wathel's concern for putting the proper motion into these displays.
It adds life. Otherwise, what do you have? You have a diorama, a museum diorama with static figures in it. And when you finally get it finished, you feel a great satisfaction on it. Then you walk away and say, hey, that's great. Let's try another one.
His attention to detail and his positive attitude are just two of the many ingredients that make up the fun and excitement, which is the magic of Walt Disney. That's the magic of Wathel Rogers.
Audio animatrons are going to be part of a very ambitious project you'll be able to see over here next spring at the Disney MGM Studios. It's called the Great Movie Ride. Now, it's going to be at the very end of a Hollywood boulevard with shops and restaurants, and it's a tribute to some of the great moments of Hollywood's past. Included in that ride will be some live action as well as some of the audio animatrons. Okay, everybody at home, try and say audio animatrons three times fast. Hey, not bad.